The following is a presentation of Santa Monica College.
Welcome to Santa Monica, California. We are live at Santa Monica College for the Santa Monica College Corsairs versus the Antelope Valley Marauders. I'm Will Pollock, here with Chelo Anglu.
Trevor Angoni, like always. Will, right here with you, buddy.
I'm horrible old names,
It's all good, buddy. I think I was calling you Bill Polian from the Indiana Colts for the first couple of broadcasts. Don't even worry about it.
We will be joined momentarily by Ashley Antelope, our sideline reporter. We got quite the game for you here today.
Yes, we do. So, Will, right now you've got Antelope Valley. They're currently ranked fifth in the state and third in Southern California. So, obviously, they're on their way to the playoffs. You know, really, really big implications in this game tonight. You know, the Corsairs are just playing for pride. They're trying to defend their home court. But ABC, you know, this is as good as they've done in about 5 to 6 years. You know, if they can win their next couple of games, they'll secure their first conference title since 2008. So, really a lot to look forward to. Now, that being said, you know, they've lost their last two games here at the SMC gym. So, again, it's one of those rivalry games. We know more than anybody, you never know what's going to happen in the rivalry games.
Who do they need to step up to take on Santa Monica College?
Well, you know, like always, you know, we're talking about, you know, Kalen Horton. He's going to be out, unfortunately. So, once again, Madison Higgins. And I think our sideline reporter has a little bit more on Madison Higgins.
We're going to go down to Ashley Aloff right now, down the sidelines.
Thanks, guys. Kalen Horton is still out with a back injury. That means this SMC team is going to be looking towards Madison Higgins to lead the charge in this game. He is the number three scorer in conference. You're also going to want to keep a lookout for Antelope Valley's Ismail Ali, who is the number two in assists and steals in the conference. Back to you guys in the booth.
Thanks a lot, Ashley. We're about to get the tip off here. And this game is underway. Antelope Valley will control of the ball.
Nothing like a division rival matchup, Will. Well, that's an early whistle.
6 seconds in. All right, starting for Santa Monica College, number 0, Jerry Shevlin. Number 5, Adam Griffin. Number 12, Marcus Harris. Number 14, Ronnie Price. And number 23, Lake Carter. And for the visiting Antelope Valley, we have Lawrence White at number 2. Number 4, Lusiwan Ogamiz. Number 11, DeLeon Draper. Number 12, Zachary Hollis. And number 20, Ismail Ali. Exciting game we have today.
A very exciting game. Well, it's a little early for a first foul for the Corsairs. You really have to watch that. You know, the worst thing is when they get into early foul trouble and start giving up the one-and-ones around the 12-minute mark. So, going to really have to watch that and, you know, keep their discipline when it comes to the foul really low.
Shooting two from the line is Davion Draper. Davion, sorry.
And Draper, you know, he's number 4 in the conference in block shots with 1 a game, so might look like a wing player, Will, but you got to watch out for him defending those boards.
He'll miss his first, but he'll shoot his second. What are the key to the victory here for both teams?
Well, as we saw last game, Will, you know, Defense, baby. Right now we see the Marauders in a three-quarter court press. So, you know, it's going to, you know, take really, really good ball distribution by Jerry Shevlin to break through that. And, you know, the Marauders hang their hats on defense. So
from the wing, Harris for 3.
And that's huge, Will. If Marcus Harrison gets started off on a great foot right there, that's huge, you know. So really, really good to see him get started like that.
White, he will dish. Hand on the ball is Ali.
Nice defensive presence by the Corsairs. Looks like they're going to start off in a little bit of a zone, Will.
Ghazim shoots for 3, and he makes the bucket.
Now, when you do start out in those zones, unfortunately, you give up those three-point opportunities. You give up the long jump shot, so they really just got to keep their eyes on that.
It looks like we could have a high-scoring game here.
Yeah,
Griffin crosses over. Harris, 4-3!
2 for 2, Will. Great way to start for Marcus Harris.
And it looks like he could have got fouled there, but it was not called. Looked like there was some contact.
And Marcus Harris, not the guy that's normally known for three-point shooting, so what a great start for the Corsairs so far, Will.
Yeah. Great ball movement here by Antelope Valley as they work the perimeter. Ali dishes over to White. White to Ali. Ali to White. Gamiz. He'll find Ali in the corner. He'll drive. He'll dish. And they will make the basket. Putting it in is Draper.
Yeah, Draper, you know, like we said, well, looks like a wing player, but really has a presence down low on the block. You know, looks like, you know, you can't really give him those open looks or else you're going to pay for it later in the game.
Shevlin will dribble. Shevlin gets it back. He'll try to drive in, cross behind his back, fake the shot, come up and get fouled. He'll head to the line and shoot two.
Yeah, great presence of mind by Jerry Shevlin. You know, he is the premier ball handler for these Corsairs. You know, he's a great slasher, gets great looks for all the guys on the perimeter, cutting to the basket. So if he can keep the ball in his hands, stay out of foul trouble, you know, he has a great head on his shoulders. He knows how to draw the fouls like he just did. So just, you know, keep your eye on Jerry Shevlin. You know, he is the motor that drives this team offensively.
At great pace set. Very exciting opening minutes of this game.
It is, Will. Yeah, this definitely you know, has a very high level of excitement, you know, compared to you know, the onset of other games that we've covered here in this gym.
Matching threes coast to coast to open the game. And he'll miss the second.
Yeah.
Ali will dribble up.
Already some high-powered offense coming from both ends, Will.
Griffin will defend. Ali will take it coast to coast and lay it in.
And there's Ali. Well, you really have to keep your eyes on Ali. You know, he's a great ball handler. He's number two in the league in steals. He's number two in assists as well. You know, so you can automatically tell he's going to have the ball in his hand, so you got to keep your eyes on him.
Great spin move of Griffin. He'll hit the rim and not get, come down with it. There's a fight for the ball. Ali comes up with it and gets it to Draper. Draper behind his back and dribbles up court around two Santa Monica defenders. And a tough attack to the hole by Zachary Hollis, and he will go to the line.
Yeah, and it's going to take everything the Corsairs have to give you know, the Marauders a good game, Will. You know, like we talked about pregame, you know, they're going for their first conference championships in 2008. They're on a nice road to the playoffs. So, you know, right now the Corsairs, you know, when it comes down to these division rival games, you can always take a little bit of solace knowing that you played spoiler in some, you know, areas. So right now, division matchup, you know, playing here at SMC, you know, you got your pride on the line here at your home court. So we'll just have to wait and see what they can do.
Antelope Valley is coached by John Taylor, who has had an impressive career at head coach.
Interesting, Will. Yeah, you know, John Taylor joined by assistants Mike Rios, Dante Bell, and Ryan Frazier. You know, a coach like this, you know, you can tell in a season like this, you know, where they're going to hopefully try to get their first conference title in 5 years. You know, when it comes to that, you know, coaching has such a huge impact on a team like this. You know, you can just tell, you know, just by where the team stands. Like, look at that full court press on the onset. It's a great call right there by Frazier.
Yeah, he's got a 700-plus winning percentage. I believe he has 87 wins in his career coaching.
Looks like he's on his way to perhaps a Division II or Division I shot if he can, you know, get the Marauders into a good position for the conference here, Will.
Santa Monica will dribble down. Griffin will dish. And he will find Harris Jr.
Yeah, Griffin is also a very underrated ball handler, Will. You know, he can get really good looks for his teammates. He can also knock it down from three. So keep your eyes on Adam Griffin as well.
And Santa Monica has a great sixth man with Thompson coming off the bench.
Huge. He's a great replacement for Jerry Shevlin in some parts, and you know, in some instances, Will. You know, a very good ball handler and, you know, can also knock down the mid-range
Griffin
jumper.
Griffin for three, and it is good.
Huge shot by Adam Griffin. You know, we've seen him hit early threes before, Will. Hopefully it's a driving factor in his confidence boosting throughout this game.
Ali handles, covered by Griffin. He skips around, and another turnover by Antelope Valley. Shevlin, he'll attack, he'll dribble, dish it out. Griffin, oh, he rims out, but defense, offensive rebound by Harris Jr., and Griffin follows through with a nice little floater for two.
He's got that confidence going, Will. He looks great. You know, he's has no hesitation calling his own number, so that's really good to see on this onset.
Oh, great little floater just dropped right in.
Fantastic. A lot of energy here to start this game on both sides. Well, just an exciting game. Even, you know, 5 minutes have gone by. Feels like a minute has it. So exciting.
And LaBelle looks like they're trying to slow it down. Ali handles. Ali gets that ball in to Draper. Or in to Hollis, pardon me. Hollis over the back foul, and that is going to Santa Monica College.
Yeah, that'll, you know, when you get the early loose balls called, you know, on a team like the Marauders, that'll kind of, you know, check them in their attempts to kind of crash the board. So, you know, everything's good for the Corsairs right now, Will.
Price will inbound, Chevron carry up. Santa Monica loves to play at a fast pace. They use a lot of subs.
Yeah, Jerome Jenkins, he likes keeping his guys fresh, Will. And, you know, if the Marauders will allow them to do that,
Griffin,
then all the better.
Can't drop, falls on the ground, no foul called. Ali dribbles up. He'll find White. White will drive, dish it out, and turnover. Hollis cannot handle the rock. Thompson is checked in this game, He dishes over, and they're going to call a foul. No, they're going to call a travel.
Yeah, probably a travel on Ronnie Price right there, Will. You know, you got to love the energy and the intensity, but they really got to, you know, kind of keep it together, reel it in, not get too crazy, because that's where those loose ball fouls and travels will come from. Yeah.
You got to love the effort. You try to do stop and go, just slid a little bit. Sometimes that happens.
Yeah, you got to just dust off the bottom of those shoes, and you'll be good to go, just like an NJB back in the day.
No one even around Draper is. He just attacks them. Nice little spin-around put-in.
And Jerome Jenkins is not happy about that, Will. You know, he is comes right onto the floor, you know, starts giving it to his players, you know, because with a team like the Marauders, you cannot afford to give them those easy layups and the easy little two-footers, the little knock-ins. They're not going to miss them, and those little baskets will add up. And before you know it, you're down 8 to 10 points by the end of the first half. Yeah. So, you know, really got to keep an eye on that.
Look how fired up he is in that huddle.
Yeah, you know, so fired up, Will, that he came out to the players. They had to huddle on the floor. You know, they didn't come back to the bench. He went out to them. And that's exactly the kind of coach that Coach Jenkins is. A lot of intensity, and, you know, his guys, you know, they'll put it all on the line for him.
14:39 left in the first half. 14-12 in favor of the Corsairs over Antelope Valley. Thompson will inbound. Shevlin dribbles up. Antelope Valley in a half court. Thompson dishes. Harris Jr. out to Griffin. Griffin controls. He'll reset. He'll find Thompson. Thompson looks to shoot. He'll drive in. And turns over the ball. Attacked by three. I thought he was going to get through that, but not able to. And Ali dishes for three. And yeah, that is Darren Took.
And you really got to keep it, you know, you can keep your eyes on Ali, Will, but he's really just going to try to get everybody else involved. So you got to, you know, keep an eye on Ali, but at the same time, look to where he's going to go with the ball.
Shevlin, he'll find Griffin. Griffin for three. Count it!
Already shooting 50%, Will, 2 for 4. You know, if he can stay around 50%, his confidence level will stay right there, so he's just got to keep pulling the trigger.
I actually think that's three. I think he's made three threes already.
Hey, great, great start for Adam Griffin.
And you know what they used to say in NBA Jam?
He's on fire.
Shevlin will handle the bar, double covered. He'll dish it out to Griffin. Griffin will find Thompson in the corner. Thompson back to Griffin in the top of the key. Shevlin will let it, will slow it down, allow his offense to set. Griffin will carry, back to Shevlin. Back to Griffin. Griffin shoots for three. Rims out, but offensive rebound by Santa Monica College.
Huge.
Shevlin will handle.
Offensive rebound is going to be huge here.
Price, a tip. That was definitely a travel by Price. Don't know what took him so long to actually call it.
Yeah, you know what? I think the defender might have got a hand on the ball. So, you know, some might have interpreted it as a jump ball, you know, traveling with a hand on the ball. But, hey, they're going to give it back to the Marauders. Marauders going to get a chance to cut it to an even game or even go up by 1 point here. But, you know, once again, you really just have to keep your eyes on Ishmael Ali. And, you know, surprising Madison Higgins on the bench to start the game. Will, something must be brewing over there, because top five in four different statistical categories, and you're going up against the number one team in conference, you want your number one guy out there, especially with Caleb Horton being out with injury.
Yeah. Tuck will handle it. He'll pass to Ali. Ali looks for the ball, and it's a turnover. Thompson with the pickoff.
Great hesitation.
Looked like Richard Sherman out there.
Yeah, great presence of mind, just waiting for him to throw the ball. He really just kind of baited him into it, Will.
That is their third foul. Ali will check out. Come in for Ali is Adrian Francis. He's 6 foot, 170-pound freshman.
Yeah, and DJ Harris making an appearance in the backcourt, Will. You haven't seen a lot of that so far this season. Maybe replacing Madison Higgins so far.
Woo!
Adam Griffin, wow, is, like you said, Will, he is on fire. He needs to keep
absolutely
pulling that trigger. He needs to heat check himself the rest of this first half.
And on the ball is Francis, covered by Griffin. Antelope Valley trying to attack. Moving the ball around the perimeter. Francis dishes to White. Back to Francis. White shoots three.
Yeah, and this team is not shy about shooting jump shots, Will, and they convert. You know, they're good around the perimeter, just inside the perimeter. Corsairs doing a good job of keeping the low post defended, but, you know, Marauders are hitting their jump shots.
Yeah, we're 11 minutes and 52 seconds in. The score is 20-18 in favor of Santa Monica College. So much action in this game so far.
And, you know, I think Adam Griffin is really calling his own number because of a Madison Higgins, you know, not being in there to start this game. Well, we're almost at the halfway point of this first half. Madison Higgins still not in there, so you can see where Jerry Shevlin and Adam Griffin will call their number a little bit more often at this point.
And Lake Carter will check back in for Harris Jr. as well as Shevlin. DJ Harris will also check out. So Francis will dribble up, covered by Griffin.
You know, I know they called a travel on that play before, but really our guy got pushed into it. Will, he got pushed into the travel, so we're going to have to really keep an eye on the refs. You know, when you have a team like the Marauders coming in, number one ranked team, a lot of times they'll get the benefit of the call, so we'll have to keep an eye on that, Will.
Our refs for today's game are John Reed, Tim Marion, and Lou Keckerson. Francis handles the top of the key. He'll dish in. Shaw goes down hard.
Foul call against Adam Griffin. Picking up his first personal.
Pardon me, that's Camille Holden. Camille Holden will shoot two from the line. 20-18 in favor of Santa Monica College Corsairs.
Yeah, and, you know, both teams off to a good start. You know, really great to see Adam Griffin get off to such a hot start, Will, especially with Madison Higgins being on the bench for some reason. So, you know, we're going to have to really have to see if he can keep calling his number and, you know, keep that hot streak going. Finally, we got Madison Higgins checking in. Looks like it was a first half of the first half situation. So now we'll see if the Corsairs can really get into an offensive, you know, juggernaut type of swing.
He'll shoot. It will rim out 20-19 in favor of the Corsairs.
Good to see Lake Carter in there too, Will. You know, dominating the boards down low for the Corsairs, yep. Usually, so really good to see.
He's had some huge games this year. Shevlin dishes. Drive. Doesn't go. That was a nice little flare by Mike Ratliff. He's checked into this game. Francis will handle, covered by Griffin. Francis to White. White spin around, take. He'll attack. And he'll go down hard and no foul. That was all ball, and he looks like he's slow to get up. Griffin falls. Great save.
Great job by Jerry Shevlin getting back on D, Will.
Oh, what an effort by the Santa Monica College on all aspects of this game. They're moving at such a high velocity. And count him. Lake Carter.
When Lake Carter's hitting jump shots, Will, this team is firing on all cylinders. It's great to see.
They really are. They are just full steam ahead. Torpedoes full steam ahead.
Absolutely.
Great defense. They're trapping him in the corner. Francis will hold. Took. Back to White. 12 left in the shot clock. And we have a foul called. 10:02 remains, 22-19. So much action so far in this game, Trevor.
A ton of excitement, Will. Great way to start this game. You know, just really, really fun to watch. You know, whenever you have a basketball game like this, you know, nobody's losing. So really, really great to watch.
It makes it really easy to get into games like this.
It does. It throws you into it. And before you know it, the first half's over because you're having such a good time watching.
Pretty nice crowd here, too, on this Saturday evening.
Yeah, definitely.
In Santa Monica. Beautiful day outside. Beautiful day for some basketball.
Well, with the Marauders having so much at stake, you can see. Oh! Wow, that would have been the most exciting play I've seen all season if he could have got it to convert. Looks like that was Ryan Wright missing the alley-oop one-handed slam. I love, great play call though, Will. It was ran to perfection, he just couldn't convert it.
Yeah. Looked like it was a little bit of showboat in there. Had he used two hands,
he might have cocked it back a little bit. Yeah, no, he could have.
We'll see if that's going to come back to haunt him, see what this game's like. It's looking like it's going to be a close game.
That's something to remember, absolutely.
What a drive. Price lost the handle, but able to pull it in, but does not finish. Great, great defense here by Santa Monica College.
Yeah, Madison Higgins all over the place. Just a fast player, you know, all over the top fives in the conference, Will. So, you know, really great to see him going.
Dishes to Higgins. Higgins back to Shevlin. Shevlin out. Lake Carter from 17 feet away.
Huge. If Lake Carter can keep hitting that jump shot from the free throw line, Will, then the Corsairs are going to have a great shot at pulling this game out.
Francis will dribble. Covered by Higgins. Higgins slides out. Great pass on baseline. But picked away by Tyler James. But it will stay with the Marauders. The Marauders.
And when you have that kind of excitement, you know, when your team's playing well, you know, it's just going to give you more confidence. It's going to lead to more good opportunities and more great defensive plays.
And a foul is called. Santa Monica with five fouls. Antelope Valley with three. 24-19, 19-15 remains in favor of the Corsairs. Francis dribbles, covered by Carter. Carter, great defense, able to get a hand on the ball, and Higgins comes out with it, and it's a race. He'll get the Shevlin.
A lot of traffic there, Will. You know, maybe take it yourself next time, but...
Or dribble back out, perhaps.
Yeah.
Reset.
You always like the unselfishness, but it's a four-point swing at that point, so...
Great finish there at the basket for number 32, DeGee Shaw. Oh, and we got a charge call. Great awareness and great control of the body by number 24, Ryan Wright. And that's a big kid to fall down. 220, 6'5".
Yeah, really good defense on both ends, Will. You know, a lot of good help, man. You know, it's really good to see. You know, when they're putting all their effort into the defensive end, then you know it's going to turn into offensive chances. So really, really good to see.
And Anua and Griffin will check in this game.
Yeah, you don't see Anua, you know, that much. So we'll see if Adam Griffin can get back in the swing of things hitting that three ball.
Francis will handle. And we got a 5-second violation called on Francis.
Wow, you don't see that call too often, but these refs stand on top of it.
Pretty good refereeing so far in this game. Griffin will carry. He'll call for Carter to come back. And Carter is fouled.
That's good. Give Madison a free look at a three. See if you know he can dial it in.
And that foul is on Timothy Johnson. He's a 6-foot sophomore, 190 pounds. Griffin has, he'll dish. Higgins for three. Off the rim and rebounded by White.
You know, the more attempts he'll get, you know, he can start to lock it in a little bit more, Will. So, you know, just good that he's getting the opportunities out of his system so far.
Some sloppy ball hit on there by White, but able to control it. Francis, he'll bounce it. That was Johnson that goes down. No foul call. It was a clean play, and Higgins will dribble up. Higgins will find Griffin.
Yeah, you got to see if they can get Griffin some good looks from three like they did in the first part of the first half, Will. It's going to be real interesting to see if they can
Lake,
keep him going.
Lake goes for the pick, and he'll shoot from that 17-foot shot that he's been hitting pretty well tonight.
You know what? Didn't convert that one, but he has to keep shooting it. You know, he can convert it, and he knows that, so he has to just keep it going.
And it's looked pretty sweet going in.
It has.
Johnson handles. Griffin on defense. He'll rotate with Francis. Francis will take it. White has the rock. He'll dish down low. Back out, intercepted by Griffin. That ball is thrown away by Zachary Hollis. And Griffin for three at the top of the key. Hits the rim and hits it twice and comes out.
Trying to see if he can jump back into the swing of things, Will. You know, with Madison Higgins back out there, I should really look for the two of them and Jerry Shevlin to make an impact on this game.
Antelope Valley has it. Johnson will carry. Francis comes out to help, or White comes out to help. He'll control, covered by Higgins. Francis. And they're going to call a foul on Higgins.
Yeah, another foul on... you know, that being said, Will, you know, Corsairs and the Marauders are doing a good job kind of keeping the fouls at a minimum. You know, that's why the game's been so exciting. There hasn't been a lot of stop play. You know, they've just been running back and forth, a lot of good transition play. So hopefully it'll stay that way because it's been a lot of fun to watch so far.
Trey Thompson will check back in the game. As well as Anthony Harris Jr. So Francis will shoot from the line. He'll make his first. They are now in the bonus, so they will shoot one for one.
Well, at least they're, you know, they're still in one for one, you know, so it's always interesting to see, you know, when you have the shooting guards, the point guards, usually they're pretty money from the free throw line, and no exception here.
6:46 remains. 24-22 in favor of the Corsairs. Sorry, 24-23 in a very close game.
Close game and a great game.
The largest lead was only 6 points. Harris Jr. will control. He'll dish. Adieu. Back up to Price. Price will find Thompson. Griffin come out to try to help. Thompson will spin. He'll drive. He'll put it up. And it'll rim out. If he would have made that, would have been an amazing circus shot.
That would have been worthy of the NBA, Will. Yeah, you'll see those crazy circus shots going. You know, I don't think he had anyone to pass it off to, so that's where the, kind of last chance situation. You know, you really had nothing else to do with the ball, so you had to throw it up there.
And we got a timeout call, 30-second timeout by Santa Monica College.
Yeah, really, really fun close game, Will. Really nice to see a great bout right here tonight. Definitely.
Great crowd here tonight. Listen to the electric in this building.
Yeah, great crowd here tonight. You know, when you have a team like the Marauders who have so much on the line, haven't won a conference since 2008, you know, you have a crowd like this, it'll turn out, you know, especially late in the season when it means so much.
I just can't believe the electricity that both these teams have had. And we haven't seen Ali come in quite a while.
That's a great point, Will. You know, we really haven't. You know, maybe they're just trying to save him for the last 6 minutes or, you know, I don't know. If I didn't notice. Okay, well, it looks like...
Let's check back in.
Yeah, it looks like he is back in. That was a pretty extended break, though. So maybe just trying to save him for the last part of the first half, I would think. We probably won't see him leave the game the next 6 minutes here.
And we have a whistle.
Maybe a clock issue. Looks like we maybe didn't start the clock.
30 seconds remain on the shot clock. Griffin will handle him, covered by Ali. He'll find Thompson. Thompson will spin. Gilmore is on him. Griffin will take it up. He'll dribble down. Griffin using his pivot foot. He'll find Anunue. And he will go to the line. I'm sorry, that's Harris Jr.
Yeah, Anthony Harris Jr. Way to get the foul called, Will. You know, just go hard into the paint and see what you can get him to call.
Harris Jr. will shoot two.
Yeah, great defense, Will, but just really, really good offense to go with it. You know, they're not blowing the doors off, you know, only 24-23, but just the excitement of the game, you know, doesn't really have you wanting for any more.
So Harris Jr. will shoot two.
That's exactly what the Corsairs need. They just need to get if they can hit their free throws, if they can hit their easy shots and their layups, you know, that's, you know, a huge part of, you know, securing the victory.
He can't finish the second one. 25-23, 5:40 remains in the first half. Ali will dribble. He'll dish out. And the basket is good by Draper.
Yeah, Draper, once again, not the guy you expect to maybe get it to go from the outside, Will, but, you know, this team is very, you know, 1-5, very fluid.
They'll jump out to their first lead since early on in the first half. Harris Jr. passes. Griffin dishes out, and they'll call a kickball.
Yeah, kickball in the Marauder, so Corsairs will keep possession here, Will.
19 left on the shot clock. Checking into the game for Ryan Wright is number 32, Tagee Shaw. Thompson handles. He'll find Griffin. And a turnover. Price, airing the ball, and they will call.
Yeah, looks like they're going to call Price on the blocking foul going the other way. You know, just trying to go for the loose ball, but a little bit of incidental contact, but nonetheless, they'll call.
And that looks to be a good call. Good hustle by both players.
Yeah, that was good hustle.
Can't really blame him for that play. But Thompson will sit. And coming in for him is... Higgins checked in. Number three, Will. And Price is coming out for number three, Will Taylor.
Yeah, Will Taylor, funny enough, Will, you know, he doesn't have a ton of shot up, you know, attempts, but he's still top five in three-point percentage, coming in at number four with 42%. So you would think a guy top five in the conference in three-point percentage, you would try to get him more looks, but, you know, he's really just content, you know, taking his opportunities when he gets them, and, you know, when he does take them, he converts most of the time.
Absolutely. And Ali puts them up by three. Griffin will carry.
And Ali, once again, making all the difference for this team. If he's not assisting, he's scoring. So, there again, picks Adam Griffin clean in the backcourt.
And great attack in the rim, putting it in there.
And just like that, you know, the Marauders are up five with under 5 minutes to go. So, Corsairs have to be real careful not to let this get out of hand.
And you see a little miscommunication there. Higgins giving a look at Griffin. You know, you just got to take that and you got to play. Go after the player.
Yeah, just like that, down by seven, you know. So, you know, Corsairs need to keep that intensity at that high tempo and really just, you know, see if they can get back into maybe a less than a five-point game, Will, because when you start to get to seven, then you're going to start to get to 10 and 12, and after that, it's, you know, it starts to balloon, and it's a little too much to handle, you know.
We'll be back. Welcome back to Santa Monica College. 4:38 remaining in the first half, 32-25 in favor of Antelope Valley.
Yeah, just like that, lead balloons up to seven, Will, so we'll have to see if the Corsairs can cut it down. Intense defense by the Marauders to start to close the second half.
Higgins for three, hits the rim and it's out. And Antelope, what a great save. Griffin dishes. And Santa Monica College will shoot 1-1. Madison Higgins will go to the line. Griffin, he'll inbound. Ball is tipped away.
And there's the first dunk of the night, Will.
Yeah, dangerous pass there by Santa Monica College.
Yeah.
Griffin will take it and slow it down. Antelope Valley's brought this lead to nine. Griffin attacks and puts it in.
Without Adam Griffin tonight, Will, this game will be a lot more out of hand. So really, really nice of you know, Griffin to show up, hit those threes, get those nice runners in the lane. Really good to see.
So Ali will kick it down. He will find Draper. Draper in the corner for three. Hits the front of the rim and bounces in.
Now that's
what an odd shot.
That's a shooter's roll, Will, and that's exactly what the Corsairs did not need right there.
So here comes Griffin. He'll Harris shooter back to Griffin. Woo! And shooting for
Adam Griffin
three.
Once again, Will, he's got to keep it going because you know, if he keeps shooting the way he is, then he can single-handedly bring these Corsairs back into this game.
And that is a huge basket to cut the lead to seven with 3 minutes and 17 seconds left in the first half.
Yeah, you really got to, you know, not only cut it to seven, you got to try to cut it to under five to really put the pressure on the Marauders and not give them the peace of mind that they can just kind of, you know, run it out the second half.
Yeah. We'll be back. Welcome back to Santa Monica. 37-30 is the score in favor of Antelope Valley over the Santa Monica College Corsairs. 30-17 remains in the first half. Both teams are in the bonus. Santa Monica with 8 fouls, Antelope Valley with 6.
Yeah, hopefully they'll keep it exciting and we won't have to deal with too many trips to the free throw line to close out this first half, Will.
So Ali will dribble up. He will dish the to White. Ali handles. And he will pass it on. White back to White. Draper. He'll take. He'll dish out. Back out to White. Dish out. That was Tim Gilmore controlling the ball. And that is a shot clock violation.
That is a shot clock violation. I'm glad they called that. Looks like they might have let it go, but he definitely didn't have it off in time. I'll tell you one thing about this Marauders team, Will, though. They can definitely move the ball and get each other involved. I think we saw each player on the offense touch the ball maybe 3 or 4 times.
Great ball movement, working all aspects of the court. So it's really enjoyable to watch.
Yeah, really, really fun to watch so far. Yeah.
So Griffin will drive in. He will find Taylor. Will Taylor back to Griffin. Higgins will push off. And Griffin will turn it over. And Ali will go up and finish at the rim.
Yeah, and you can just see the talent on this Marauders team, Will. You know, Corsairs kept it real close for the most part of this first half. But, you know, already up to 9. So it's going to take a really big effort for the Corsairs. Just Woo! Like that, Will.
Harris Jr.
Anthony Harris Jr. hitting it from
Count
the corner.
Count it from the arc.
Great to see, Will. That's exactly what they needed. Exactly what they needed.
Santa Monica, they are shooting amazingly from behind the arc tonight.
And they should really try to get more opportunities because that's really working for them, Will.
Ali handles. Gets over to Draper. Pardon me, Gilmore. White from the corner for 3. Rims out. And that ball is staying with Antelope Valley. Nobody could get their hands on it.
And right now you got Coach Jenkins. You know, he's talking to the refs right now, Will. He really thought there should have been a loose ball foul called on that, and I agree. You know, it was pretty, you know, easy call to me. Looks like it was an easy call to Coach Jenkins. But once again, we're not the ones out there. You know, these refs are calling a pretty good game so far. So, you know, you got to cut them a break. They're not going to get every call. So, you know, still good to see.
1:42 remaining in the first half here in Santa Monica, California. Antelope Valley inbounds. Ali handles. Dishes to White. Spin move. Out. Gilmore. Back to Ali. Ali will set the offense. Into the corner. Gilmore for 3. Rims out. Griffin to White. Fight for the ball. Griffin comes out and he'll race down. Griffin sets the offense.
Oh, just like we talked about in the first half, Will, you put your arms up, and just like that, you can create turnovers. Yeah. It's that easy.
Well, they got to come back and help Griffin. He's being double-teamed.
Especially
they're trapping him.
You got a guy. He was not only double-teamed, you had a guy on him who was probably 6'5", 6'4". That guy puts his arms up. He's over 7 feet, so you really do have to help the guy out.
Higgins is right there. Couldn't get up there for it. The Antelope Valley will take the ball. Draper shoots. Makes it.
Draper, Will, I'd say he's probably been the standout for the Marauders offensively in the first half. You know, he's doing stuff you don't expect him to really do.
Under a minute to play in the first half. 41-33 in favor of Antelope Valley. Higgins will carry. He'll fake, spin, dish. Woo. DJ Harris makes it for 3.
You're never going to expect DJ Harris to come out and hit a 3, so that's just icing, Will. That's just extra on top. That's all you can ask for.
Draper handles. And a turnover. Higgins, he'll take it. To the rim, not able to finish, and a hard foul.
Hard foul. We'll see if Harris can get back to the free throw line, cut this to even 3 points. Well, what a close by the Corsairs in this first half.
So much energy on this court from both teams.
Really great to see.
So exciting. We're standing up.
Yeah, both these teams have us out of our seats, and, you know, if we add anybody after halftime here, these stands aren't going to be able to hold any more people. Really, really, like you said earlier, great turnout so far today.
So Harris will shoot. He'll make his first. 28 seconds left. 8 fouls for Santa Monica College, 7 for Antelope Valley. Adrian Francis will check in the game.
Yeah, and DJ Harris will just, doing exactly what his team needs, doing exactly what is asked of him, hitting open shots and converting free throws. That's all you can ask of your players.
So a quick turnaround, was a 9-point lead, quickly turns to a 3-point lead. So White will handle, he'll give the ball to Ali. They'll hold for last shot, the shot clock is off. White will handle, back to Francis, back to Ali. 5 to play, Ali will drive. He'll dish. Wow. And he puts it home. That basket was scored by Taiji Shaw. So your score going in the half, 43-38 in favor of the Antelope Valley Marauders.
And unfortunately, Will, when you have the ball in Ishmael's hands at the end of that, I mean, if you're looking for the Marauders, you have one more attempt to go for the rest of the half. As soon as Ishmael gets the ball in his hands, you double team him. But you saw what happened. I think they did double team him and left the post wide open. So their offense begins and ends with Ishmael.
Well, we're about to go down to our sideline. Ashley Alloff is with the head coach of Antelope Valley. Down to you, Ashley.
Coach, what did you like from your team in the first half?
I like the energy that we're playing with. I think the guys are doing a good job communicating and scrambling around, playing on defense.
And what is it going to take to keep the lead in the second?
I think we have to stop the shooting. They've hit a lot of threes from the corner and the wing, so that's what we got to stop.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Back to you guys in the booth.
And it is 43-38 in favor of the Antelope Valley. How is Santa Monica staying in this game? Like, the three-point shooting in this game on both sides is unreal.
It could have been a lot worse, Will. Like we saw, they were upwards of 10 points, but the Corsairs closed that first half just ferociously. It was amazing to see. Only a 5-point game, could have been 3, but, just really, really great to see either way.
Great play by Ali from Antelope Valley. What's their key to keeping the lead, and what's Santa Monica's key to getting that lead back?
I think defense, Will. More than anything, it's going to be defense, just like we talked about. But when we say defense, it's going to come down to the Corsairs' ability to break down that defense like they did late in that first half. So, just really, really great close offensively by the Corsairs. Great to see Adam Griffin get off like he did. Jerry Shevlin, not necessarily making his impact like he normally does, but, with Madison Higgins and especially Adam Griffin doing what they're doing, that's all you can ask for the Corsairs. So, really great to see so far.
43-38 is the score. Antelope Valley leads, but what a run by Santa Monica College down the stretch. Griffin stepping up big. Shevlin stepping up big. Harris stepping up big.
Huge.
What a game we've had so far.
Yeah.
What are the keys for these teams?
I mean, right now, Will, the way that we closed that first half and cut it from like a 10-point game down to 2 at one point, or 3 rather, then they pushed it back up to 5, but right now, 5 points, against this top team in the conference, that's really all you can ask for. What we do have to really try to see what the Corsairs can do is if they can produce points like they did in the first half, Carter at the top of the key, Adam Griffin from 3-point range. We'll just see if they can keep it going like they did in the first half.
Well, let's get back to the action. We're about to go underway here in the second half. Santa Monica College will start. Inbounds to Shevlin. Shevlin will dribble up. He's being trapped. He'll get over to Griffin. Griffin over to Price. They'll run Harris, Price, Griffin, Shevlin, and Carter. But that ball is stolen by White and put in.
Yeah, that's exactly what the Corsairs can't really afford right now, Will, is breakaway easy layups.
The Marauders will run with White.
But if Adam Griffin can keep shooting threes like he just did right there, Will, then that'll make all the difference in this half.
White tries to answer back with a 3, but it will not fall. I'm sorry, Gamiz. There's Shevlin. He'll drive in. Give off to Griffin. Griffin off to Price. Price will drive in. Go up.
Looks like it's going to be Marauders ball on the jump ball call there, Will.
Be possession Marauders.
Kind of thought they could have called it a travel as well.
Yeah, at least Corsairs get the next possession.
Or an up and down.
That's where you can come away with that, I suppose. It's like Coach Jenkins doing a little impromptu court cleaning right there, a little bit of a wet spot.
Hollis will inbound him to Ali. Ali will dribble up. Shevlin will step. Draper controls. White has ball. He'll give it back to Drape, or back to Ali, and back to Galim. Carter controls the ball. Back to Chevron. Carter puts the pick on Ali. Santa Monica College running the clock down here, setting up a play.
Yeah, you know, I like the fact that they're at least taking their time while they're trying to set up a play. Better than just driving the lane and throwing up a prayer.
Price finds Shetland in the corner. He'll drive. He'll dish out to Carter. Carter fakes, pass. He'll drive in. Double coverage. Goes up. And he is fouled. He will shoot two from the line.
Yeah, Carter's offense has been huge so far in this game. Well, you don't really expect, you know, Carter to be a big offensive juggernaut, but those jump shots in the first half, getting to the line, that's all you can ask for.
Carter's lucky he didn't get hit with a 3-second call there.
Yeah, you know, these refs have not been shy about calling the 3- and 5-second calls. You know, just see if Carter can convert on the free throw line. You know, when you got a big guy who can convert from the line, that makes all the difference, Will. Yeah.
Draper will rebound off the missed shot by Carter.
And this is the guy you got to keep your eye on, Ishmael. He's the guy, you know, ball in his hands. He's the one who got the great opportunity at the end of the first half. Got to keep your eye on him, but who he's going to get the ball to more than anything.
Draper controls. Griffin almost came up with a steal from behind. Back to Ali. Ali gets past Griffin. He'll take, he'll dish, and he will make the basket. What a trick play.
Ali does not miss when he's that close to the basket. Well, that's why you really got to just try to prevent him from slashing in.
Griffin will dribble down, slowing the pace down. Carter will come for the pick, will walk off of it. Carter loses the handle, but Carter is there to grab it. He will shoot from 13, and that ball will not drop. Rebounded by Draper. He'll air it down to White. I'm sorry, to Gamiz.
And right there, well, once again, Damian Draper, you know, he's the guy who you would think, you know, he's top five in rebounds, but you don't expect him to hit from the perimeter like he's been doing.
And just like that, the score is back up to 8 in favor of Antelope Valley. And an air ball shot there by Price. And a dunk by White.
Yeah, nice hops right there by number 2, Will. You know, really impressive. You don't really expect that out of him.
Exactly what I was about to say. I did not expect White to have that dunk.
You expect him to pretty much more so be running the point.
And that ball is off the hands of Draper. That will stay with Santa Monica College with 21 seconds on the shot clock. The largest lead of this game, 52-42 in favor of Antelope Valley.
Yeah, and you know, just like we talked about, you would have hoped that the Corsairs could come out of the gates, you know, a little bit more offensive efficiency, a little bit better defense. You know, right now, Marauders off to a good start, giving themselves a nice little lead moving into the second part of the second half.
Well, Trevor, what does Santa Monica College have to do to get back in this game?
You know, we saw a lot of great shots from Adam Griffin. We saw a lot of great offense from Lake Carter. And even number 12 earlier in the first half, Will, Marcus Harris. You know, we haven't seen anything out of them so far. But Madison Higgins back in the game finally. You know, they're going to need some offense out of him, Carter, Shevlin, Harris, anywhere they can get it really well.
I'm surprised I haven't seen Thomas check back into the game.
Yeah, you know, it's
or Thompson, sorry.
It's interesting so far. You know, I mean, like we were just talking about, so far, you know, you've got Marauders pretty much having their way. They're up 12 after a 5. Madison Higgins is the number one guy who's going to bring this team back at this point, Will.
Great take by Higgins to cut the deficit back to 10. 15:50 remains in the second half. 54-44 in favor of the Marauders. And that ball will stay.
Yeah, and number 2, Lawrence White, Will, you know, he's getting back to that dunk again. You know, he has to have a pretty incredible vertical for being one of the smallest guys on the floor. You know, definitely has that really high leaping skill set that can really pave ways for you, you know, in the different types of leagues you might find yourself after junior college. You know, maybe Division 2 or Division 1 or even overseas. Once again, there's that baseline out of bounds play. Set up perfectly, got the look, but just could not convert.
Yeah, that was
just taking the first half.
That was Tagee Shaw that made the attempt. The second miss of a dunk by Tagee Shaw. And on the other end, Harris finishing at the rim.
And Shaw, you know, he's one of their big guys. He's top 5 in the conference in rebounds, coming in at number 5 with 5.8 a game.
Marcus Harris and Thompson have checked into this game for the Corsairs. Griffin, 4-3, rims out, but rebounded by Santa Monica College. Great effort for that offensive rebound.
And that's what it's going to take for the Corsairs to get back. Adam Griffin hitting his shots, just like that one.
Great floater by Griffin. Madison Griffin is just on fire tonight.
Yeah, you know, he had the threes going in the first half, Will. If he could just get those threes going again in his second half and start converting those little easy attempts, then Corsairs will have a way better shot at it.
Santa Monica College has cut this lead back to 6. Ali handles the rock. He has Gamiza in the back to help him, but that ball is put in there, and another dunk by Antelope Valley.
Yeah, Tavay Shaw, Will, we haven't heard a lot from him, but he's got that big body, and he can definitely throw it down there on the low block.
He's a 6'5", 215-pound freshman.
Great defense by the Marauders right there, swatting it out of Madison Higgins' hands. We'll have to see if the Corsairs can turn it around here.
And the lead is back to 8. Unable to finish, but they come down with the offensive rebound. Offensive rebounds will kill you. And count it. He will go to the line and shoot the extra.
Yeah, there he is again, Ismail Ali. Will, you know, coming out of San Leandro High, you know, just has a great skill set as a point guard. He can get great looks for his team on the perimeter, cutting to the basket. You know, he's a maestro out there on the floor.
He really is exciting to watch.
Yeah, very impressive.
58-48 in favor of Antelope Valley. He does not make the extra shot. Shevlin will handle the ball.
Speaking of Shevlin, we haven't seen a lot of Shevlin this game. You know, when the Corsairs were really hitting all cylinders, he's slashing, he's driving the lane. And he is not only doing that, but he is getting to the rack and he's getting the layup. So, you know, it would be nice to see a little bit more out of Jerry Shevlin today. It seems like he kind of, you know, he's either killing it one game and he's really kind of non-existent the next. So really interesting to see if he can pick it up the second half.
White will inbound. Ali will handle. He'll attack the rim. Won't make it. But Gamiz will come up with that rebound. He'll back it out to Ali. Gamiz will get his hand on it, and it will stay. Thompson knocks that ball out of bounds.
A lot of tenacity.
Thompson thought he had that off of Gamiz, but it'll stay.
Tenacious D by Trey Thompson, averaging about 5 points a game. So, you know, a bucket from a Trey Thompson or, you know, a Marcus Harris, you know, they can make all the difference in the world right now, Will.
Ali hands off to White.
Just like we just talked about, you got number 11, Trey Thompson. Great defense there, Will.
Yeah. Spectacular defense on that play. Here's Harris. He'll drive. Dish to Harris Jr. Pardon me. To Antelope.
Now, like we always talk about, Will, converting from the free throw line. You have to hit the free ones.
So Antelope will head to the line. He will shoot 2.
Pretty solid from the free throw line. It's you know, being one of their bigs and all, Will. You know, coming in about 6'1", you know, really nice when they can hit their free throws.
And he shoots for 2. He makes 1 of 2. That ball was rebounded out by Shaw. Ali handles. He's covered by Griffin. Gamiz dishes over to Ali. Ali dribbles around. Over to White. White into Shaw. Shaw comes in. Can't get it, but he will go to the line.
Free throws all stemming from Ismail Ali. You know, just dropping dimes, Will. You know, getting the defense to move around the court. You know, just got really good vision.
Now, we talked about what Santa Monica College needs to do to get back in this game. What does Antelope Valley need to do to keep Santa Monica out of this game?
They need to keep doing what they're doing. You know, their defense in the second half has really picked up. You know, they're not letting Adam Griffin get 3 attempts. They're not letting Carter get shots from the top of the key. You know, Madison Higgins hasn't been able to establish himself yet. And Jerry Shevlin has really been non-existent this game. So far in the second half, with about 7 minutes gone by, you know, they're doing a great job just shutting down all the big difference makers for the Corsairs.
All right, he will shoot his 2 of 2. He made the first, will not make the second.
Yeah, and the Corsairs will need every break they can get at this point, Will.
DJ Harris will dribble down. Dishes out to Thompson. Thompson has the corner. He'll find Griffin. Griffin back out to Harris. Harris tries to find Thompson corner, but that ball is intercepted by White.
Yeah, Marauders trying a little three-quarter court D on that defensive possession before, and it seemed to work.
And Francis is checked in for Ali. Gamiz handles. Back to Francis. To Gamiz. He'll try to penetrate, but can't get in. He'll find White. White dishes over court to Gamiz. He shoots, but can't get it to drop. Shaw, the rebound.
Yeah, they're just getting completely outworked on the low post. Will, you know, they're getting out-rebounded, giving offensive rebound opportunities to the Marauders. Yeah, you know, and you can't survive.
You can't give up 3-4 attempts, and that's what's happening here.
Not at all, and that's going to be the biggest problem for them moving forward.
So Gilmore will attempt two free throws. I believe that's Gilmore. No, that is Shaw. No, that is Holden.
Hey, well, hey, looks like we're cleaning out the rosters at this point. Well, getting everybody some minutes. You know, I mean, if you look at the first half, you know, you had DJ Harris, you know, converting on a three and a couple of
beautiful three,
couple of free throws. You know, so you never know where you might be able to get help at this point.
It's a great rebound there to give the possession back to Santa Monica College by Tyler James. Harris dishing the corner, but way over the head of Will Taylor.
Yeah, and, you know, Harris is a little confused on that one, but, you know, that even the tallest guy on the floor wouldn't be able to come down with that one, Will.
So odd rotation Santa Monica College has in right now.
Yeah, you know, a lot of guys that you're not used to seeing. You know, that sometimes, though, is exactly what you need to get back into the game. Give the other team looks that they haven't seen before.
Another great play by Tyler James, but somehow the ball winds up out of bounds, so it will stay with Antelope Valley. But great effort on defense by Tyler James.
Yeah, very interesting to see. You know, the Corsairs' entire starting lineup on the sideline. It's just very interesting to see them all over there, Will.
Francis will handle, covered by Harris. DJ Harris covering Francis. Francis will dish for three. That ball will not drop for Took.
Great rebound for Tyler James right there, Will. You know, really good body, you know, as far as size. You know, Tyler James, I believe it was against Citrus, you know, did a great job defending the low post and defending those really athletic bigs. He's got a really good vertical, so we'll see if he could do the same thing against the Marauders.
Francis will handle the rock. Back to Took. To Francis. He'll drop that to Draper. Draper, I thought Draper had the inside, so he shoots the fadeaway, and that is a good, that was a beautiful fadeaway shot.
And I'm telling you, Will, every time Draper has shot the ball, it's looked good, and he's converted on most of his shots, so surprised he's not calling his number a little bit more often.
19-foot shot there, just off the three-pot shot. Draper for three. That rims out.
Right now,
Harris will carry down. Ooh, and a hard foul on Harris.
Yeah, Corsairs are having a hard time getting a rebound even when it's 4-on-1, Will. So, you know, very interesting to see, you know, the flow of the game at this point. Very different half, you know, very completely different from the first half, you know.
13-point lead for Antelope Valley. I was not expecting this at the beginning of the second half.
Yeah, you know, you would hope for the same type of intensity we saw in the first half from the Corsairs, but, you know, just not there right now, Will.
And there's a three by Will Taylor.
Once again, Will Taylor, top five in the conference in three-point percentage. Will, he's got to really call his number more often.
And again, when you think Santa Monica College is about to get blown away, they jump right back in the game.
And if they could just keep the defensive rebounding high, convert their offensive opportunities, they can cut this lead.
Harris dribbles in. Goes by his back, loses it, but gets control. Cross-court pass. And Chevin will check back into the game. Got to expect that Griffin and a couple others will be coming back in a few moments, too.
replacing Kamal Holden.
Ten minutes remain, 52-62 in favor of Antelope Valley. Both teams still have four timeouts, four fouls for the Corsairs, three for the Marauders. 26 seconds left on the shot clock as Santa Monica College inbounds the ball.
Yeah, once again, Jerry Shevlin with the ball. He, you know, still hasn't made his imprint on this game yet, Will.
No, he hasn't. But look for him to do that. He has the ability to take games over when he needs to.
Because when he's doing well, Will, it just looks so good. He has such a smooth style, slashing to the rim and getting people good looks. So we'll just have to wait and see if he can get anybody going.
What a fake by Harris.
Oh, it looks so good too, Will.
I thought it was going to get on that second drop.
Yeah, I thought it had a real good chance of going in.
Francis with control. Taking Draper, just throws up a prayer.
And they're letting them play, Will. Refs are definitely letting them play, which is good to see.
Yeah, here's Shevlin with a spin move for three. Can't drop it. Ratliff with the rebound. Spin, take, and that won't drop, but he will go to the line. He will shoot two.
You know, if only Jerry Shevlin could have converted that crossover, he made the Marauder defender fall over and pretty much roll over at the top of the key. It would have been a beautiful thing to see him convert that three.
They're hanging around. It's all you ask your team to do. You know, cut that lead, be within 10 in a certain time.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Within 5 minutes, be within like six, you know?
Foul call going number five, Adrian Francis, picking up his first personal.
Yeah, like you said, Will, really full house tonight. A lot of family and friends of all the players here. Just a really good atmosphere here at the Corsair Gym.
Got these kids down here. It looks like they just recently saw the Lego movie. Legos going on.
We've got the next generation Corsair football players and basketball stars here joining us.
53-62. Ratliff goes one of two. And Ratliff with the steal. Oh, but taken back by Francis. Great effort by Ratliff. And then Ratliff comes in tight, and their legs tangle up, and they both fall down. And it looks like the referee thought there was something getting a little chippy there, but I didn't really see anything chippy happening.
Yeah, you know, I mean, once again, you know, at this level, you have a lot of kind of herding or, you know, grouping going on a lot of the times. Really hard for these refs to kind of decipher what's going on. So, you know, we'll have to take their word for it, but, you know, they are letting them play a little bit in the second half. So, you know, not disappointed with what they're doing,
yeah.
But, you know, the refs in general, you know, doing a good job tonight.
Draper has possession. Intercepted by Tyler James, and that is the third time he's come down to play like that.
Yeah, it looks like the Corsairs kind of have figured out that inbound slam play, Will. Oh, that would have been huge.
Will Taylor from the corner looked good, but rims out. Another great play.
Tyler James all over the place defensively, Will.
Chevron has possession. Ratliff will step up on Francis. Ismail Ali looks to be checking in at the next stoppage.
Looks like he'll probably finish the game, Will, so be nice if the Corsairs can get a basket or two here before the next whistle.
Griffin cannot get control, and an easy bucket and dunk for White.
Yep.
And a timeout taken, 64-53 in favor of Antelope Valley. 8:13 remains in the second half. Santa Monica has five fouls, the Marauders with four. Four timeouts for the Corsairs, 3-4 Antelope Valley.
Yeah, still a lot of time left in this game, Will. You know, only down by about 11 with 8 minutes to go. If the Corsairs could just try to get that offense going, that's been the one thing that's been missing this half, has been the offense like the last half, Will.
Chevron will handle, he'll cut the two defenders, and he will be fouled. That is the fifth foul for the Marauders. Next one, they will be over bonus.
Yeah, Corsairs doing a good job, you know. Not necessarily in bonus, you know, at the 12-minute mark, you know. If they can keep it down about the 6-7-minute mark, you know, that's a little bit more acceptable, so.
So there, Griffin will handle. Harris Jr. passes out to Chevron. In the corner is Taylor. He cannot get it to drop and rebounded by Antelope Valley. Ali handles, covered by Griffin.
Yeah, Ollie breaking it down. And once again, great assist, Will. You know, when he gets the ball, he drives down the lane. He's anywhere in the paint. He's either going to get a little layup or he's going to get somebody a great look. So
yeah.
Really hard to game plan for that guy.
And capitalizing on that great look was Draper with another dunk.
Absolutely.
So let's see. This is the largest tie for the largest lead of the game. Let's see if Santa Monica College can push it back and get back in it.
2 points.
Great job by Tyler James. He has been huge today. 11 points with 7 minutes remained. Gamiz out to Ali.
Uh-oh, you got Ishmael at the top to keep the ball, Will. This usually doesn't end well.
He'll set, reset. 10 on the shot clock. Ali dishes in the corner of Gamiz. Cross over to White. White takes a look. He'll step back. Take a two. No foul called. Rebound by Santa Monica. Will Taylor with it. Shevlin pushes it up. Underneath.
Yep, and one.
And one for Tyler James.
And that is where Jerry Shevlin is best used, Will. When he's slashing down the lane and getting guys good looks, he is no more valuable to his team when he's doing that.
And just like that, a 13-point lead is cut down to 9. Possibly 8
maybe
with a make.
And right now you got doubt starting to creep into the minds of the Marauders, Will. That's exactly what you got to do. You got to put pressure on them. If they don't have any pressure on them, then, you know, their confidence is going to stay the same. They're going to still hit shots. So, you know, very important to put the pressure on the Marauders.
He cannot close it out, but it's a 9-point lead for Antelope Valley. Gamiz back to Ali. Ali handles, covered by Griffin. He'll drive, he'll dish. Gamiz takes it on the baseline. He stepped out of bounds and the referee completely missed that. His foot stepped on the line and the ref completely missed it on the baseline.
Yeah, he can't miss those, Will, but I'll tell you, this Marauders team is probably one of the most athletic teams we've seen all season.
Higgins is checked into the game for Santa Monica. He has come up empty. It's been a pretty quiet night for Higgins.
And not only are they athletic, Will, but their coach knows exactly what plays to call to get that athleticness showcased. You know, so, you know, really interesting to see, you know, just the difference in styles where, you know, the Corsairs, it's not like they're not athletic, but the Marauders, you know, they just have figured out a way to showcase that athleticness.
Higgins take dishes. Griffin. Griffin's been pretty quiet the second half as well.
Very quiet. Pretty much non-existent, Will.
But he will go to the line. He will shoot the bonus, one for one.
Nice shot of our SMC cheerleaders right here, who just recently finished sixth at Nationals in Florida. So congratulations to the Corsairs representing for Southern California.
Yeah, absolutely, congratulations. Wonderful on the mats, doing great flips. I can only imagine. I don't know how they can do that
really
stuff.
Really fun to watch, Will. But I'll tell you what, Adam Griffin missing free throws, that's exactly what the Corsairs cannot afford right now.
Able to come up with the second one. And we have a timeout. No, I'm sorry, we have a substitution. Number 21, Tim Gilmore will check into the game. And for the Corsairs, Clark will check back in.
And you know, the Marauders have just completely blown this second half. You know, it would seem they've completely blown up this second half, but the Corsairs still within 10 with 5.5 to go, Will. Still not completely out of it.
Kind of surprised we haven't seen Thompson in recently either.
And looks like a loose ball foul going the other way, Will.
Over the back foul called on, I believe that's Gilmore. I'm sorry. No, that's Ryan Wright. The foul is on Ryan Wright. So they will shoot one for one. And that is now 8 fouls. That could be very beneficial with the time that Santa Monica College has left. Griffin will shoot. He makes his first. So they've cut it back down to a 9-point lead. And Griffin will shoot his second.
Yeah, if we can just keep converting here, Will, you know, keep, you know, just chipping away at that little by little. It was 13 a minute ago. Now it's under 10. I think we're at 8 now. you know, like we said, Will, chipping away still a little over 5 minutes, an eternity with an eight-point game at this point.
Yeah, like they have eight fouls right now, so they could very easily, you know, be in the double bonus.
Exactly.
Which could put Antelope Valley in jeopardy here.
Oh,
and a hard foul.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration coming through, Will. You know, when you have Ali, he's been completely dissecting your defense all night. He gets to the rim again, and you're really just going to hack him and put him on the line. I mean, it's better than, I guess, getting their morale boosted with another slam dunk. So,
yeah.
You know.
To 60 in favor of Antelope Valley. Just under five to play. Both teams in the bonus. And Ali will miss his first. That's huge for the Corsairs.
Yeah, they can, you know, they need everything they can get at this point, Will. And a player like Ali, you're not used to him missing a free throw. He probably won't miss the second one. So you got to, you know, take everything you can get. Take advantage of just the one-point conversion at this end.
Ali set the shoot. He'll make the second. Harris will inbound. Shevlin pushes up the court. Higgins has it. Shevlin back to Higgins. Back to Shevlin. Crosses to Harris. Harris for three. Count it!
And just like the beginning of the game, Will, Harris knocking down that corner three. He hasn't tried it the second half, but he should try it a lot more the last 4.5 minutes.
And somehow, some way, Santa Monica College has cut this lead to six.
Like we said, Will, a lot of time left. Still 4.5 minutes left. Ton of time left.
Great defense there by Shevlin.
Great D, down low by Marcus Harris.
Harris pulling down the rebound. He'll pass over to Shevlin, and they'll push it up the court.
Owning the boards.
He'll find Higgins in the corner for three.
Oh.
Off the brim. And they cannot come down the rebound.
This place would have gone crazy if he could have hit that, Will.
Ali will attack the rim. Can't finish. Santa Monica up.
Oh. And like we always say, Will, the defensive rebounds is what's going to win you the game. You cannot give up second opportunities, offensive rebounds, and little chip-ins like that. It just completely, you know, defeats the purpose of what you're trying to do out there.
Yeah, Zachary Hollis completely gripped that ball out of Shevlin's hand and just put it in there. And we're looking again at an eight-point lead. But Corsairs are not in a bad position. They're not out of this game. There's a lot of fight left in them. There's a lot of time left.
Ton of time, Will. And, you know, Marcus Harris from the corner, Madison Higgins, Adam Griffin. You know, if we could just call some plays that get them open looks, I mean, that's going to make all the difference in the world at this point. You really have to just get your good players good looks. And that's where Jerry Shevlin comes into play. You know, when he can slash and get guys great looks, you know, this team is a completely different animal. So, you know, just really, really, you know, going to be interesting to see if Jerry can really kind of pry his way in there and get the offense loosened up a little bit.
71-63 here at the Pavilion at Santa Monica College in favor of Antelope Valley. 4 minutes remain in this second half. It's been quite a battle by both teams. It's been quite a battle here by both teams.
And you know what? Corsair's done a great job closing it in. You know, we're only 8 points with possession at this point, Will. If they can knock down to three, you know, you're down to five. Even putting it into two, you're down to six. But it's going to come down to getting those defensive rebounds, not letting the Marauders get the offensive opportunities. You really just have to you have to play perfect for the next 4 minutes.
Shevlin will handle. He'll drive. He'll dish out.
Now, that should be off on the Marauders.
And that'll stay with Santa Monica College.
A lot of time left. 22 seconds still. A lot of time.
Great job by Harris to just let it go. Shevlin will handle, 20 on the shot clock. And that's a turnover by Santa Monica College. That's a huge turnover.
Yeah, with under 4 minutes, Will, like we said, they have to play perfect, and turnovers is not playing perfect. So
you need to score in every possession here.
Absolutely.
Santa Monica cannot give opportunities up. Ali will push the ball. Ali handles.
Looks like Marauders maybe try to take a little bit of time off the clock, Will, but you just got to be real weary when Ali's got the ball in his hands.
Mm-hmm. White, who has thrown it down a couple times tonight, will dish to Gilmore. Back to White. Back to Ali. And they are content with running time off the clock. Five left on the shot clock. He'll get it to White. White for three.
count it.
And that is that's everything everything a dagger is, Will. You know, right when you're trying to cut the lead and then they push it back to 11, that's a backbreaker right there.
Yeah, that was probably the nail.
Probably. It's going to take an incredible last 3.5 minutes from the Corsairs to close this lead.
Or the proverbial straw.
Yes.
Draper will dish it over, but he will be fouled. He will go to the line. 2:44 left, 74-63, and a little 11-point lead for Antelope Valley over Santa Monica College.
Yeah, and the clock keeps ticking away, and we were down to about 6 or 7 at one point, but now we're back up to 11. You know, if we were still in that 6, 7, 8-point range with 2:45 left, but with the Marauders going to the line here, Will, the chances just chances Corsair is going to come back, just keep dwindling and dwindling at this point.
Yeah, that clock, it just keeps tick, 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 tick. The clock is your enemy as much as your opponent is your enemy at times, and your clock is your best friend.
Especially late, and that's been one of the, an issue the Corsairs have had all season is that, they can close real well, but, at the early onset, getting the shots to go and getting in their rhythm, they have a hard time with that a lot of the time.
Yeah.
So, it's too bad.
Clock management is one of the most important parts of any game. Looks like we have a player being attended to.
Yeah, maybe a cut or something. It looks like maybe a pulled muscle or something like that.
You would think they would make him sub out, but giving them a little leeway.
Gosh, and you look over at the Corsairs bench. They got so many players, don't have room for them all to sit on the bench. You got Harris sitting on the floor at the end of the bench.
That was Zachary Hollis that was being attended to. Draper will shoot. He'll miss. But rebounded by Hollis.
Like we've talked about all game, Will, you cannot give up the offensive rebounds. When you do that, you're done. And, I think this game is as close to the refrigerator as it's going to be.
13-point lead here with 2:30 remaining. Shepland dishes out. Harris for three. Rims out. Santa Monica comes up with the rebound and then loses it. Ali has it. He'll pass up to Draper. Draper will take the foul. Will not get the basket, but he will shoot two.
Yeah, you got to really, respect the way that the Corsairs came out at the beginning of the game, Will. They really challenged early, but, the talent on the Marauders roster is just too much to overcome, especially when you have, a player like Madison Higgins not playing the first half of the first half and also not starting the second half, We know that Madison has, had a very interesting relationship with Coach Jenkins, and, he hasn't started certain games. But, against a team like the Marauders, you really got to try to come to a common ground and try to win the game more than anything. That being said, definitely, can't question Coach Jenkins' coaching ability. Top of his game, and definitely one of the best coaches we have here on campus.
Yeah. Don't let Coach Strong or Coach Giff hear you say that, though. Yeah. Coach Giff is right there.
He's an earshot away here, Coach.
Coach Giff, the head football coach here at Santa Monica College.
Yeah, we had Coach Giff do a little halftime presentation, a little bit of appreciation for the men's football team who won their third straight conference championship this year. So, in Coach Giff's third year coaching, so just incredible things Coach Wenheim's been able to do for that men's team.
Some great players have played college football here, have started their career here.
Absolutely.
You got Chad Johnson,
Steve Smith,
Isaac Bruce.
Yeah, funny enough, some really big time electric wide receivers and guys that aren't shy about letting the other team know.
That is so true.
Hey, if only Marcus Harris could have, Anthony Harris Jr., if he could have gotten that going a little bit more in the first half, if he could have gotten a little bit going in the first half, but really what it comes down for me, Will, you've got Shevlin, you've got Higgins, you've got Griffin. I mean, what have they done the second half? As far as I know, nothing.
It's like what it could have should you,
Exactly.
It's what you could have done, what you should have done, what you did do.
Exactly.
They showed up tonight. They played.
They did show up.
They just played a team that, they're going somewhere.
They are.
They are a very dominant team.
They are primed to win their first conference title since 2008. Looks like they're definitely going to the playoffs. And, with a battery like they have here with Ishmael and, their low post presence, they should be doing things in the postseason, Will.
Yeah, I mean, you don't take anything away from Santa Monica here, you know. Like, everything you just said is completely and utterly true about this team. Sometimes you play good teams.
Absolutely. And, sometimes the other team, you know, stacked the way they are, you know, just hard to overcome pure talent, Will.
Mm-hmm. And when you have players like White and Draper that can just dunk the ball down, and you have outside shooters like Ali and, like, you can attack the rim as well. I mean, there's so many different aspects that you have to be able to play defense.
Yeah, absolutely. Looks like Marauders are just going to take as much time off the clock as they can. That will go ahead and clinch the game here, Will.
Great effort there for Santa Monica College. Harris, kind of an odd play under the basket, but he dishes it out.
Yeah, great blend of speed and size for this Marauders team, Will. You know, they got the defensive presence with the bigs down low. They've got really fast guards, so really, really good blend of talent.
So we're under a minute here. 12-point lead for Antelope Valley. Draper. Santa Monica doesn't look the foul. Take it. Refs doing a good job of not calling stupid fouls here. Griffin will carry up. Shoot for three. Won't make it. Rebounded by Antelope Valley. And that should about wrap this game up.
That should do it well.
Shot clock is off, and they will just hold the ball.
You know, just as we saw with, Adam missing that last shot, that's kind of been a microcosm of this whole half. You know, just all of the Corsairs' top scorers unable to get going in the game. And, you know, if only, I guess, Will, you know?
Mm-hmm. Great effort by Santa Monica College, but they come up just short. They fall by 12 by Antelope Valley, who's looking on to move on, go in the playoffs. How far do you think this team can go?
I mean, top of the Western State South, Will, you know, if you're top of our conference, you know, all of the L.A. players and that talent pool, I mean, I think you're looking at contenders for the state championship, perhaps.
All right, we're going to go down to our sideline reporter, Ashley Alloff.
Coach, you guys were close in the first half, but lost a little bit of your offensive charge in the second. Walk me through what happened there.
Well, give Antelope Valley a lot of credit. They're a very good basketball team. That's why they're in first place in our league. You know, we just had a lot of injuries this year that's kind of caught up to us, and we're just struggling right now. But we know we can get that program in the future, so the future is bright for us.
Madison Higgins, number three scorer in conference right now, didn't start the first or the second half. Is there a reason for that?
Nope, he just didn't start.
All right, thank you for your time.
All right, thank you.
Back to you guys in the booth.
Thank you, Ashley. There you have it, Chris from Coach JJ. He's very very coy with his words sometimes, isn't he?
Very coy, very curt. He's a smooth talker. You know, I think we tried to get to the bottom of the Madison Higgins thing before, and he was very, very smooth with letting us kind of figure it out on our own. So, you know, but like we said in the broadcast, you really can't question Coach Jenkins. You know, he's a fantastic coach, and he always has his team primed, you know, to play very, very well. Just couldn't get the offense going in the second half tonight.
Yeah, a great showing in the first half. 9 threes they made. It's a great learning experience. We'll see you next week live here at Santa Monica College. Have a great night.